Hello students of standard 9. In geography, you are learning about the types of mountains. Through the previous video, you have learned about the first type, that is fold mountain, and the types of fold mountain, that is old fold mountain and young fold mountain. Today, you are going to learn the second type of the mountain, that is block mountains. So the block mountains, what are the block mountains? If you see the diagram, the flat topped with steep sides are the block mountains. They do not have conical peak, they have always flat top. How are they formed? They are formed due to the tensional and compressional forces. In the areas of the earth crust where the layers of the crust is made of hard rocks, instead of bending they form cracks. So due to the compressional forces in different direction, parallel cracks are formed in the earth's crust, and instead of bending, faulting takes place. And because of faulting, these parallel faults are formed. When the landmass between these two parallel cracks sinks down or subsides, it forms a valley that is known as rift valley, and beside it, which upraised parts are found or formed, they are the black mountains. It also forms in different way. And this another way is when the landmass between two parallel cracks upraises due to the vertical compressional force, upward movement takes place the land between the two parallel cracks. When it upraised, it forms block mountains, and beside this upraised block mountains, two rift valleys are formed. So, wherever block mountains are formed, side by side, rift valleys are also formed. So, what are the main features of block mountains? You should remember always, block mountains have flat top and steep sides. And what are the main features of rift valleys? They are the flat bottom valleys with steep sides. So, wherever block mountains are formed, rift valleys are also formed. Some of the rift valleys and block mountains are found in different countries and continents. In Europe, Vosges Mountain in France, Black Forest in Germany. In Africa, whole Eastern Africa is full of many rift valleys and many block mountains. In India, Narmada River Valley is also an example of block mountains and rift valleys. So, you should remember the formation of block mountains, which takes place in two ways. When the landmass between two parallel cracks sinks down or subsides, the upraised part besides this valley forms block mountains, and the sinking part, which is forming a valley, that is rift valley. And second way is the landmass between two parallel cracks, due to the internal pressure which is vertically pushed up or upraises, that forms block mountains. And beside this, the lower part or the valley, which is formed rift valley. So wherever there are block mountains, there are rift valleys. The next type, the third type of mountain, is residual mountains. What do you mean by residual mountains? The word residue is indeed indicating that it is the left part of a mountain. So in the ancient period, many high mountains were formed many millions years ago. And after many million years, they have been changed into low-lying, dome-shaped with gentle slope mountains, and they are the residual mountains. So the high mountains are changed into lower mountain due to the agents of gradation. In the areas where there is heavy rainfall, water or river water is the main agent. In the ice cap region, the main agent is glacier, and in the desert region, the main agent is wind. So these are able to change the high mountain into a low lying mountain having dome shaped top and gentle slope. So this type of mountains are known as residual mountains. There are some examples in different parts of our world. So there's a Appalachian in North America, also Ural Mountain between Europe and Asia, and in India Aravali Mountain. These are some examples of residual mountain. And also in Jharkhand, Parasnath and Rajmahal Hills are also examples of residual mountains. You should know the significance of mountains. What are the significance of mountains? These mountains are the source of many perennial rivers, and these are the fast flowing rivers when they form waterfalls, and when they are the swift rivers, they are very important for generating hydroelectricity. The slopes of the hills are very good for terrace farming. There are also plantation agriculture in the parts of Assam region. Also in peninsular India, the slopes of the Nilgiri Hills or Annamalai Hills, also they are the grazing yards for the domestic animals. They provide scenic beauty. There are many hill stations located on the higher altitude of the mountains, and due to their pleasant climatic condition, cool climatic condition and scenic beauty, many tourists attract to this region, and that becomes a center of tourist attraction. So mountains are also rich in many minerals. Many important minerals are found, and they are the raw materials for many industries. Mountains having very dense forested areas, they provide lot of forest products. They are also, the mountains are able to form mountain barrier, and they help to bring rainfall in the areas where they lie. So like this, if you see the significance of mountains, there are many significance and importance of mountains you should remember. Thank you.